Hey there, YouTube. How's everybody doing today? So I wanted to take a couple minutes and do some race recap with you guys. So yesterday was the Vincentown Super Sprint Triathlon, my first triathlon. So just going to kind of go through some of the steps that I went through. I have some other footage I'll add into the video here of the bike ride. Some pictures I took leading up to it, some video footage leading up to the race itself. So I just wanted to talk through some of that, kind of the week leading up to it and the race itself, so you guys could, hear some of the mistakes I made and some of the successes I had. So we're going to kind of start with some shipping foobars I had this week. So one is I did order a transition bag about a week ago, and FedEx had a little bit of a mix-up. So the bag that actually didn't get here till the day after the race, not a huge deal. I ended up using just another backpack. It just wasn't as organized, but you'll see how I'll add the picture in here, but of my transition area, but still ended up being pretty good. I think once I got there and I got the stuff out of the backpack and set up my transition area, it was actually pretty good. So not too bad there. And then I showed up in a wetsuit, and then once I got there, I kind of decided at that point, the temperature of the water wasn't that cold. It wasn't a super long swim, so I opted for taking off the wetsuit, and I'm kind of wishing I would have stuck to my guns and just did what my race was. And you'll hear that kind of a couple times here. There were some mistakes I made that I think I got maybe sucked into doing things that maybe I didn't plan on doing. And I think that's probably all part of becoming better at the sport that you're participating in over time and realizing that you just do what you prepare to do. And, so neither here nor there. So I ended up taking off the wetsuit and just going with my tri shorts. The water, so they tried telling me it was 4 feet deep, so it wasn't deep. Being out there, and I know I am not super tall, I'm only like 5'6", 5'7", but the water was definitely deeper than that in some spots, and then some spots it wasn't very deep. So leading up to it, I get in the water, I'm feeling really good, right? And I wish I would have had my camera with me in the water, because I'm standing there at the water, we're starting at the first buoy, and I'm just thinking, wow, this is amazing, right? So the lake is surrounded by trees, we're all standing there in the water, waiting for the whistle to blow for us to start, and I'm just like, wow, this is just like awe-inspiring, just the scene there. And I was feeling really good, right? And I think I got sucked into a little bit of a false sense of security when they were telling me the water was only 4 feet deep and blah, blah, blah. And then I had a plan going in, and this is one of the things I actually stuck to, was I was gonna let the crowd go ahead of me so I didn't get sucked into the crowd of people and get, because I'm not, I knew going into it, I'm not a strong enough swimmer that if I have people all around me swimming and drowning me, that I'm gonna be comfortable at that point in that environment, and it's gonna affect how I swim. So my plan was to kind of hang back a little bit and let everybody go, give myself a little bit of space, and then start swimming. I've been practicing swimming. I've been swimming at least 3 times a week for a little bit now, and feeling good in the pool. But, after the crowd goes, I was kind of just waiting in the water, just kind of taking a slow start, letting everybody get out ahead a little bit. And then when I start swimming, the lake was, I don't know if it was murky or whatever the case was, but I put my head in the water and I opened my eyes to swim, and I couldn't see anything. It was like I didn't even open my eyes. And I'll tell you what, man, it gave me a panic attack. And, you know, and I've watched some videos and I've heard some people talk about, you know, I got in the water, it was my open water swim, and I started panicking and it just threw off my whole swim. And I'll be honest with you, I really wasn't, I mean, I knew the swim was going to be hard for me because it was my first open water swim in a competitive environment. And I knew that I just, that was my weakest of the three sports. But when I went to go swim, and I knew, you know, you have to practice your sighting, keep an eye on the buoys. And again, this is all, I guess, just experience, right, with time. But I put my head in that water, and it was like I was swimming in the dark, and I panicked. And so you start panicking, right? And any of you that have ever had a panic attack before knows your breathing gets real short and shallow, and yeah, you can't breathe right. Your body starts getting stiff. And I'm just, at this point, I'm breaststroking because I'm not putting my head in the water. And I'm like, I start telling myself, right, I'm rationalizing. I'm trying to figure out ways to calm myself down so I can get through the swim at this point, right? And so I'm like, just put your feet down, right, for a second, gather yourself, and then start swimming again. And this is where I found out the water really wasn't 4 feet deep. Maybe out at the last buoy it was 4 feet deep, but in this circumstance, I go to put my feet down and there's no floor. So the water was definitely at least 7, maybe 8 feet deep at that point. And I just dropped. And then I start panicking more because then I'm like, I can't stand and I'm freaking out. And I'm not gonna lie, I was close at this point to waving at the lady in the canoe and saying, hey, come get me. But I started doing the breaststroke or doggy paddling, whatever you call it. And I kept telling myself to breathe. And I made it through. It wasn't easy. And I will tell you that I will practice the breaststroke and other strokes more now that I know what I know being out there. I will continue to obviously practice freestyle and the normal, you know, way of swimming. But yeah, I definitely need to get more efficient with other strokes, because the other end of it is that doing a breaststroke for 0.2 miles was significantly tougher than a freestyle swim, and I cramped up. So, you know, now I'm in the beginning of this race and I have a major cramp in my left side. Excuse me. So then I go, I finally get to the swim, I get out, and at this point I'm trying just to recover myself because I'm having a full-blown panic attack. I'm telling myself to breathe. I get into transition. My transition took a little longer than I would have liked. And again, I think these are things I have to practice more leading into my next race. Good thing is I have a lot of lead up time to the next race with Corona and everything else going on in the world. There won't be another triathlon until probably next spring, maybe early summer, where I, you know, so I have plenty of time to prep and practice these, you know, different things leading up to the next one. So I get into transition. I don't want to say I pulled myself together yet, because I really didn't pull myself together until about a mile into my ride. And so I get moving on the bike. I get out of transition, I hop on my bike, and I'm breathing really heavy, and I'm kind of just trying to pull myself out of the panic attack that I'm having. And it wasn't till probably about a mile in that I got my breath and started pulling myself back together. So at this point, the first minute of the first mile of the ride was not my best riding, but then it picked up as I was going. I started feeling my pace a little bit. And overall, the ride wasn't all that bad, right? So I ended up picking up the pace on the ride. Ended up going, I think I averaged probably right around 14 miles an hour on the ride. I get through the ride, And I still have this cramp in my side at this point. And then this leads into the next thing that I need to do more of is what's called brick runs, where you ride your bike for a while and then you hop off your bike and as soon as you can go for a run within a few minutes. And again, I don't know if it was the fact that I was getting off my bike and going for a run or if it was the fact that I've had a cramp since I breaststroked 250 meters. Either way, I get off, I have this major cramp, I flip my shoes, you know, and I had elastic laces in my shoes. So, I mean, that transition went a whole lot better. And then I went to go run and my legs just didn't want to move. That cramp had me all jacked up. I ran a little bit, I walked, and it just wasn't happening. So I got through it, right? I kept moving. I didn't stop moving, right? I kept telling myself, you can do anything but quit, right? That's the one thing you can't do at this point. You are not allowed to stop. So I kept moving. And when I could run, I ran a little bit. When the cramps started getting too bad, then I would back off the run and I'd start walking a fast pace, right? With my short legs, I walked as fast as I could. And I just kept moving. And then I ran into the finish line, and it was done. I completed my first triathlon. Listen, I'll say a couple things. One, I definitely was nowhere near the time I was hoping to complete this in. And it, you know, it's fine. It is what it is, right? You learn, and moving forward, hopefully, you know, you do things better. I'm glad I finished. I'm glad I didn't give in to my panic attack that I had while I was swimming. You know, definitely many opportunities to do better in the future. But I love the sport. I can tell you that if I walked away, you know, sometimes you do something and it's hard and you walk away, you're like, oh shit, I ain't never doing that again. I walked away and it was hard and I was hurting and I was cramping and all these other things, but I realized that I love the sport. I love swimming, I love biking, I love running. I definitely got to figure out something with my swimming. Nutrition obviously is an opportunity. I will tell you, I put that video out earlier in the week that I flipped around my fasting windows, and I'll tell you what, I jacked myself up. I didn't feel great. Not that I felt sick or anything, but I just didn't feel right all week. I should have stuck to my fasting window, and the day before, I should have just ate earlier in the day, and the day of the race, I should have just ate a little earlier so I had some calories in me and just went about my day. Switching my fasting around in the beginning of the week and being off of my normal routine really did not help me at all. I don't know if it made things worse, but it definitely didn't help me any. So that's something that I got to do a little bit more research. Again, I mean, listen, I only signed up for this thing like 4 weeks ago, 4 weeks ago. So, you know, kind of an impulse because it was really the only race going on this year, and I didn't want to miss an opportunity to get some experience under my belt and learn about transitions and swimming in open water and all these different things. And I've learned now, and it was a great opportunity. It was a great experience, and I learned a lot. But definitely some opportunities. So, listen, thank you to everybody for following along in this journey. We still have a long way to go. We're not stopping now. I'm hoping to start hearing from more people about their experiences and their training and their nutrition, and hearing, you know, some of the successes that you guys have had. I've had a couple great comments, I don't have my computer in front of me, so I don't know the names right off the top of my head, but a couple of you guys were talking about electrolyte drinks and wishing me luck in my first triathlon. So thank you guys. Those comments mean the world to me, and I'll keep communicating and responding back as soon as possible, and I'll talk to everybody soon. So until next time, stay healthy, find your happy, and seek to inspire. Have a great day. I'll talk to you soon. Bye.